Hello everyone, greetings to you all. My name is Daniel Ranjan. I am a student of Vellore Institute of Technology, Chennai. Today, the topic I have chosen to discuss is rotating charged wormholes via Neumann-Jannes algorithm. Wormholes are solutions of Einstein field equations that allow passage between two different space-time or two different regions of the same space-time. In this presentation, I am going to discuss how we are obtaining a rotating charge metric from a stationary Morristown wormhole metric. First, let's discuss about charged wormholes. The notion of charged wormholes in general Morristown wormhole is introduced by Song Wong Kim and Hyun-Joon Lee in the year 2001. The metric introduced by them is equation number 1. This metric is a combination of Morristown spacetime and Reisner Nordstrom spacetime. When the charge Q becomes tends to 0, the metric will reduce to Morristown wormhole with phi of r equal to 0. When the throat function B of r tends to 0, the metric reduces to Oran spacetime of 0 mass. For this presentation, let us take B of r, the simplest value of B of r as a constant or not. Next, we can see about the Neumann-Jannes algorithm on charged wormholes. Neumann-Jannes algorithm is a method of obtaining a rotating metric from a stationary one. This method involves complexification of metric elements and its coordinates while the metric is in Eddington-Finkelstein coordinate system. So, suppose we take a general metric ds square is equal to minus f of r dt square plus dr square by g of r plus h of r d omega square. The rotating metric obtained using a modified Neumann-Jannes algorithm is given as equation number 3. And the resulting metric can be rewritten as equation number 4. Here we can see that the value of h is a common term to all the terms. So when we take geodesic or equation of motion using Hamilton-Jacobi equation, this h will be eliminated, which it does not affect any of these equations. For our case, for our rotating charge wormhole space-time, the delta of r, sigma of r and k of r values are given as 5, 6 and 7th equations. Equations of motions and effective potential. I have taken use the Hamilton-Jacobi method to obtain the equations of motion t dot, phi dot, theta dot and r dot. Using these equations of motion, we can find the effective potential. The effective potential is obtained from the relation r dot plus v of r, v effective of r is equal to e square. From this equation, we can arrive at an equation for effective potential. V effective is equal to e square minus r dot. So, value of r dot is given in the equations of motion, and which is root of r by rho square. Substituting in this equation, and we will get the equation for effective potential. The effective potential plot is plotted here, and as we can see, values of a and l doesn't affect much affect the shape of the effective potential plot much. It just affects the scale of the effective potential plot. But when q is altered, we can see a qualitative change. When q is equal to 1, the effective potential rises to infinity. This is a particular property of this metric. In future, we can use this metric to obtain the shadows and obtain shadows and all. Thank you.